Very good morning to everyone. In this lecture, EC8652 Wireless Communication, today we are going to discuss about the topic Diversity Techniques. So, in this presentation, the principle of diversity and what are the different types of diversity techniques, macro and micro, and also the signal combining techniques, finally we are discussing the transmitter diversity techniques. Now let us move to the basic understanding of diversity. First of all, the diversity is a good technique applied in mobile communication receiver circuits where there is a multipath environment. The diversity technique uses the nature of the propagation path characteristics for improving the sensitivity of receiver. It will improve the wireless link at less cost. It does not require the prior training because a training sequence is not needed by a transmitter like a equalizer. So the diversity techniques find a way of analyzing the signal path for multipath cellular environment. These techniques of diversity decision made at the receiver end and they are not known to be transmitter. The diversity is very efficient when the transmission channels carrier feeding copies of one signal. The joint probability density functions with the field strength of the wireless channels. So it is a simple concept of diversity that even if a radio signal path experiences a deep phase, there will be another independent signal path available for analysis. Here you can analyze the presentation. It is one of the basic understanding of the time dispersive channels. So the delayed dispersions and the time and then frequency dispersions, the signal will be faded into different format. Like we can see this picture and then we can move to the another one. This is a diversity method to follow, the diversity method to improve the dispersions of time and frequency of the channels. So the concept of this diversity, a received signal is observed with many variations. Assume two antenna with a specific separation between them are located on terminal. They experienced different fading levels as a mobile terminal move. An example here, you can focus in this picture. An example of this received signal variations are represented. The received signal level differ with their corresponding fading levels. And we select an antenna that poses higher signal level so that the probability of deep fading can be avoided. Now let us move to the diversity principles. The principle of diversity is to ensure that the same information reaches the receiver on a statistically independent channels. This is a general concept. Now let us move to the diversity. This is a technique implemented to improve the channel quality and performance. This is achieved by placing the transmitter signal in a statistically independent channels, and also it reduces the overall feeding of the received signal at the receiver side. This technique mainly addressed the feeding problems. Now let us move to the correlation coefficient. The diversity is most efficient when the different transmission channels carry the independently fed copies of the same signals. The correlation coefficient characteristics the correlation between the signals on different diversity branches, that is at polarization diversity, time, and also the frequency. So the correlation can be done on different parameters such as the complex part of the signal, the phase relationship, etc. And also the most important one is the correlation between the signal envelope. Now let us, we can see the lack of correlation understanding. So this is a same time dispersion channels of delayed information of fade in different faded signals. So we can understand in the picture level, it's a contraction level of the fading. Now first of all, we can find out the correlation coefficient, that is a modulated index of the input signal, so transmitted signal. So P x comma y is equal to E of x into y minus E of x into E of y divided by root of E of x square minus E of x square into E of x square minus E of y square, where x and y are the envelope of the receiver. The signal are said to be effectively decorrelated, and also the certain threshold value, that is a 0.5 or 0.7. Now let us move to the types of diversity techniques. So how to obtain the diversity in the signals? The diversity can be classified based on the fading method, that is a small scale fading methodology of it is a microscopic diversity technique, that is the simplest name of micro diversity, and the large scale fading effect due to the technique we are finding the technique macro diversity, that is a macroscopic diversity technique are used. Now let us move to the micro diversity method. There is a 5 method are available, that is our number 1, partial diversity. It is one of the antenna elements separated by this phase. Number 2, temporal diversity. It is a transmission of signal with a different time period. And frequency, it is transmission of signal at a different frequency levels. And angular diversity. It is a multiple antenna with a different antenna patterns. And finally, the polarization diversity. It is a multiple antenna with a different polarization. Let us discuss one by one. First of all, partial diversity method. In this method, it is one of the simplest conventional form of diversity. The transmit signal is obtained at many antenna elements. The performance of the system is influenced by correlation of the signal between the antenna elements. The space diversity schemes is also called as antenna diversity scheme. In conventional method of wireless communication, the availability of direct path between the transmitter and receiver is not assured. Hence, the occurrence of railing fading will be present. The phase diversity scheme, also called the antenna diversity method, it is another name of partial diversity method. In conventional methods of wireless communication, the availability of direct path between the transmitter and the receiver is not assured, hence the occurrence of railing fading. But the antenna space diversity can be achieved independently fading changes by applying the spatial separated antenna. Here, the large correction between the signal are undesirable. As it is decreased the effectiveness of the diversity, it is an important fact is to establish the relationship between the antenna spacing, that is different for transmitter side and different for receiver side. We can analyze the picture. In the transmitter side, we can the mobile station and then base station. So the diversity techniques, that is a diversity of antennas, that is one is a main antenna, another one diversity antenna. It can be reduced the handoff procedures and also the signal coverage informations. So on the receiver side, the transmitter antenna is sent to different received antenna. So the space diversity of the receiver configurations, the number of diversity branches selectable. For this structure, it produces the diversity reception of at each and every cells, that is every mobile stations. Multiple base station receiving antenna are used effectively. It is an important role. It maintains the scattering take place in around within the mobile unit, and hence to attain the decorrelation, the antenna to base station hence to be placed with the necessary separation distance. This separation distance can be in order to tens of wavelength value with respect to base station. Generally, the space diversity technique can be used to at a base station or a mobile station or both end of the stations. Now let us move to the temporal diversity. The temporal diversity is here one of them. Wireless propagation channels are time variant signals. For better decorrelation, the temporal distance should be include the terms of maximum of signals where the maximum Doppler frequency. So the different way by which the diversity can be realized: number one, repetition coding; number two, automatic repeat request; number three, combination of coding and interleaving. Next we are moved to the number one, repetition coding. The signal is repeated several times where the repeated interval, such as the decorrelation of signals. In this method, highly bandwidth inefficient, and also the automatic repeat request, that is a ARQ, this is a received signal, a message to transmit to indicate the whether it received the data with sufficient quality, and if not then transmission is repeated again. The efficiency is better than the reception coding. The retransmission occur only at certain causes. And finally, the combination of interleaving and coding. The signals are interleaved and code instead of sending the actual data, those code word are sent. The transmitted code word can be reconstructed. Now let us move to the frequency diversity method. The frequency diversity is implemented by transmitting the information on more than one carrier frequency. It does not mean the same messages are transmitted in the two different frequencies. When that is done, then the signals undergoes different fading levels. Instead of, the information is spreaded over a large bandwidth, so the small part of the information are convergence by the different frequency components. Then the receiver average over the different frequency to recover the original informations. Now the spreading is achieved by different methods. Number one, compressing the information in different time, that is we are using the multiple axis of time division multiplexing axis, and then the code division multiple, and then OFDM, orthogonal frequency division multiplexing, and also the frequency hopping in conjunction with the coding. So what in this frequency division, the demerits, it is required large bandwidth, and also the more number of receiver are required and very high cost. Now let us move to the angular diversity. It enhances the declaration of the signals at closely spaced antenna. The different antenna pattern can be achieved very easily. This effect is due to mutual coupling. So the angle diversity, two co-located angles antennas, that is a mutual coupled antennas, elements with a different radiation pattern. There is maybe interference due to the multipath components. This is known as antenna diversity or pattern diversity. It can be used in conjunction with the spatial diversity. It is possible to attain the different antenna patterns. Now let us move to the macro diversity. In macro diversity method, to reduce the large scale fading, macro diversity is used. So large scale fading are generally caused by shadowing. If there is an hill between the base station and also the mobile station, then simply increase the transmitting antenna and the receiving antenna does not make any difference. Thus the intermediate base station, that is a base station 2, 1 to 2, it is placed in between the base station and the mobile station, that the hills does not lies in the between the base station and base station 2. So the large scale fading are mentioned previously, the simple diversity scheme are not suitable. So in this, macro diversity is approached to method to compensate of large scale fading on the frequency repeater to receive the signal and retransmit the amplified versions. It is similar to similar from different base stations, same signal is transmitted. These base stations should be synchronized with each other. Now, if the runtime from two base station to mobile station are known as a synchronization can be obtained, the synchronization error is not larger than the delay dispersions. So the receiver amplified and or retransmitted the original signals. What are the demerits and merits of macro diversity methods? The merits: it is a distance between the base station and the mobile station is can be increased. And the demerits: it required large bandwidth and also the frequency repeater causes the delay dispersions. So delay dispersions is not only for the synchronization of errors. Thank you for watching this video.